Welcome back to Chicago Theater Review. It is still the month of May. It's spring in Chicago. And that means that it's time for the Jeff Non-Equity Awards. And luckily, one of our guests is actually on the Jeff Committee, and he's going to help explain to what's going on a little bit. They just announced a few weeks ago on their website what shows were up. And there are a lot of shows that are up for non-equity awards. And some of them we're actually going to show you. We have some clips from those shows. But I still get confused on this. What is non-equity versus equity?
Well, the fundamental difference is that theaters who are in the equity wing of the Jeff Awards, the Jeff Committee, are theaters that have a contract with the Actors' Equity. So they hire equity actors and stage managers. And sometimes that indicates that they have a little more money, and sometimes that doesn't. Then the non-equity are those theaters that don't have contracts with the union.
So basically it's either they're unionized or non-unionized.
Right.
But then you can have equity actors playing in non-equity shows?
You can, and there's usually those actors have permission from the union to be in a non-equity show.
Okay, so what's going to be coming up now in June will be non-equity.
Yes.
These are all small theater productions.
Yes.
Right. And I do want to, and I do know that Theater Ubique is up for an award. And I think they're up for 7 awards, which is that tiny little theater, which I think that stage is 15 feet long, manages to get so many nominations is unbelievable.
We didn't introduce our guest.
Oh, let's introduce them.
This is Jason Smith, Jason Paul Smith.
Yes.
And he's on the Jeff Committee, but they're actually, and this is Rob Dorn, and they're actually here to talk about something else, which we're going to get into, something that they have coming up.
They got something big coming up, which I was surprised to hear about, and what we're going to do, though, is talk about what's going on in Chicago, and there are a lot of shows that are going on in Chicago right now. The first one is, the opening was just last week, was Peter Pan. Gail?
Okay, here's the deal. It is not the musical. So if you're expecting the musical, it's actually just the story. It's in a big tent that they built at the Tribune, it's the Freedom Center, big tent. And if you look at the top of the tent, it's very, very high. These actors are actually on wires the whole time, coming down and going under the stage and all sorts of things. I loved it. I mean, for kids, I think it's really great. It's really amazing. I mean, they're just up really high, and little Tinkerbell. And
we had a 26-year-old with us who fell in love with the whole thing. And the nice thing is, it's like IMAX under a tent. So they use a large amount of projections, and the computer graphics
are
phenomenal.
It's all around you, and so when they're flying through the air, it's all moving around you, so it looks like you're going through, like, London and all these places, and it's very cool.
Well, to give you a good hint of what we're talking about, let's show the first clip.
It's really
good. I want to mention that this is a London. This cast is from London, and I think there's like 3 people from the area that are actually in the show. So everybody, the main characters, are all from London, where this was first done. So it's an excellent show. So I highly recommend it. Next is Working, and Working is playing in Chicago. It's Stud Terkel's book, and it's actually closing June 5th. That's at the Broadway Playhouse. Also, we have another show which I'm surprised is closing early too, is White Noise. And that's the Whoopi Goldberg production, which doesn't really surprise me. Like I mentioned on the last show, when the big opening night was, I don't think the message was going to get across. And I think some people were just going to take it too rough. And I think that's what the audience is thinking about it. And I know you can't say anything about it, because it's up for, it's on the Jeff thing.
And I haven't seen it yet. I'm seeing it tonight. So.
Oh, you're seeing it tonight. Okay.
I'm excited.
Next, I liked it.
She liked it. You know, the music is good. The staging is great. I think it's a little hardcore. Some people
It's meant to be
hardcore, but I think they've made it so pretty that people don't really get the message. And we'll see what you think of it after you see it tonight. Now we have another show that just opened. It's from Timeline Theater, and it's called The Front Page. And I know you saw it, and you can't say anything about it. It's a wonderful story. It was written back in the 1920s. It's about Chicago in the late 20s and the corruption that goes on in the city of Chicago. Well, the nice thing about this play is that 60 years later, the corruption is still in this city, and it hasn't really changed much. So as though it was written in the 2000s compared to the 1929s. What I want to do, though, is show a clip of that show first.
Take this restroom away from
me. That would be a break.
Yeah, this place is full of cockroaches anyway.
Wait a minute, fellas. Listen, Pete. This is the last favor I'm ever going to ask you, and it's not me that's asking to get me. You know who's asking it. A certain party is asking it. So once and for all, how about hanging this guy at 5 o'clock instead of 7? It ain't going to hurt you, and we can make the city addition.
Now, Roy, that's kind of raw. You can't hang a fella in his sleep just to please a newspaper.
No, but you could reprieve him twice, so the hanging will come 3 days before the election, so you could run on the law and order platform. You could do that, all right?
I had absolutely nothing whatsoever to do with those reprieves. That was entirely up to the governor.
And who told the governor what to do?
How do we know there won't be another reprieve tonight? For all I know, I've been hanging around here for nothing when I got a sick wife.
Yeah, with another alienist getting called in.
What, Goose? Sure, what about that? Suppose he finds out he's insane or something.
He won't find he's insane because he isn't. This ruse of reading the Declaration of Independence day and night is pure fake.
So that is called Front Page.
And let's just say Timeline has really made a name for themselves. I think every show that they do, every show that they've done, really over the past couple of years. It's such an interesting theater. You know, you go in the lobby and you get the whole history of the play, and their staging is always different, and they're very creative over there.
So this is playing until June, so I do recommend you get down there. Timeline does do excellent work, like Gail said, so you should see it. The next one we want to talk about is one of my favorite small theater companies, which is new, called Provisions Theater, and that's off on Roosevelt by St. Ignatius. And Provision does work that deals with family values, and every show they do is spectacular. And the one they have right now is called Wonders Never Cease. It's an excellent show. Basically, it's I like the way they hooked up the sets with videos, and it actually makes wonderful sense the way they did it. It's about a 7-year-old girl that sees an angel. And even though she goes to a parochial school, which is an Episcopalian school or Lutheran school, what happens when a 7-year-old tells her teacher that she saw an angel? And it takes place in this time, you know, 2011, and how people think automatically that you're crazy and stuff. It's a wonderful show. I'm not going to give away the ending or anything, but I do recommend that you get down there and see it. The next show is A Little Night Music, and that's playing at Circle Theater in Oak Park. This is their first musical they've done, and I mean the last two shows weren't musicals, so and they're using their new theater to a great start. We have a clip for that show. Let's play the clip first. So that's A Little Night Music, and that's playing at Circle Theater, which is in Oak Park. Next we want to talk about, it's at Shakespeare Theater. It's called Madness of George III. Excellent, excellent production. It's how King George went crazy and what happened during that point of the diagnosis of him being crazy and then about to lose his reign and then coming back on. Excellent casting, excellent staging, and you get a little bit of medical knowledge from it. So I do recommend it. That's also playing until June 13th. Next is a show which we've talked about before, A Twist of Water, which was playing at Theater Wit and is now moved to the new Mercury Theater. And that'll be playing until also June.
That was their inaugural production.
Their inaugural production. So it got such good reviews that they were able to move it to another theater. So I do recommend, if you haven't seen it at Theater Wit, get down to the new Mercury Theater and see it there. Next is, we have Cirque du Soleil, and we have something else which I don't even know what it is. Let's play the clip first, and I'll tell you what the show is. Let's play that clip. Okay, this actually moves us to the other show I was going to talk about, which was Cirque de Ova, which is actually starting next week. So Gail hasn't seen it yet. And, you know, they have a lot of acrobatic-type shows that come to Chicago, and they all use the Cirque idea. This is an actual Cirque show that's actually coming to Chicago, so it'll be good to finally see what they do, because otherwise you have to go to New York or Las Vegas to see most of their shows. So that's it with what's coming up. Is there any other shows you wanted to talk about?
Let's just mention that summer's coming, and so there are some things that, like, we've had every year, like Navy Pier does their Cirque thing. And, of course, I guess we can all say that Chicago's a really great city in the summer. Not so great in the winter, but it's a really great city in the summer. So besides theater, there's just so much to do. You know, Theater on the Lake is opening. So many outdoor activities, and you know, it's kind of nice to get out when you can.
We will be doing a show at Ravinia, like we've done for the last 2 years. So we'll give you the whole new schedule of what's going on in Ravinia. We will get Maggie Fouchot hopefully into the studio, or we'll go back to the Cultural Center so she can tell us what's coming up on events downtown in Chicago also, and especially what's going on with families and kids.
Frank's going to dive into the fish tank at the Shedd Aquarium.
After I lose 30 pounds. We're going to do a show at the Shedd Aquarium. That's on our list. Before we go, I do want to make one thing. We finally found an intern. Hopefully she's going to accept the position for 6 weeks. She's going to be on our next show. I want to introduce Darcy Cousins, right? Cousins. She'll be on our next show. She'll be responsible for making it look better. So from Chicago Theater Review, we'll see you next month.